that are here that want to lend their voice. So instead of reading bios that are three paragraphs long, I'm going to start bringing people up here a little bit, okay? Up next is Israel Baton. Israel is the executive director of Americans Against Antisemitism, a grassroots organization that Dov Hikin founded. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Israel Baton.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here today to speak about climate change. Yes, the climate is changing, and rapidly, and it's a real problem. The climate I'm speaking of is not the planet's, but this country's and this city's climate for Jews in dealing with anti-Semitism. The climate is putrefying before our very eyes. The climate is one where Jews constitute less than 2% of the American population, but account for more than 60% of all hate crimes. The climate is one where violent attacks against Jews in New York City have increased by more than 60% this year. And in this climate, Jews seem to have targets on their backs that say, "Punch me." The climate is one where certain members of Congress are spewing anti-Semitic vitriol with no consequence. And instead of being shunned and marginalized, they're being mainstreamed and celebrated on pop culture, TV, and magazines. The climate is one where Jewish students are being intimidated and threatened on university campuses across the country at unprecedented levels. The climate is one where Jews as a whole, again, are being demonized for the actions of the few or the actions of the State of Israel. The climate is one where tired anti-Semitic symbols like the swastika are making a comeback and being spray painted on synagogues, Jewish gravestones, Holocaust memorials, and Jewish schools. But I come here today not with the message of victimhood, because Jews are sick and tired of being victims. And we will not beat anti-Semitism by accepting such a status. No, we will defeat anti-Semitism just as we have historically, by always being prouder of our Judaism, our heritage, our history, and identity. We will defeat anti-Semitism by standing tall on our principles of pursuing justice, equality, and love for our every neighbor. Every one of us, Jewish or not, is a soldier on the front lines in this battle for our very lives. When we see something, we must say something. Whether it's at work, at school, or in public spaces, when an anti-Semite rears their ugly head, we must have the courage to speak forcefully against it. No one wants to be a 24-hour crusader, but if we turn a blind eye once, then twice, then we too become complicit in our own demise. And if they're coming for the Jews, other minorities are not far behind. Therefore, we must save our climate. And there's no debate about the numbers here. This climate change is not doomed to end the world in 10 years, and it is totally reversible. If only we can unite and fight by being resolute with an unwavering commitment to not only battle anti-Semites here or there, but all bigots and racists everywhere. Yeah! Lastly, I have a message for every anti-Semite out there. There's a reason why anti-Semitism is known as the longest hatred. The Babylonians didn't succeed in destroying us. Neither did the Greeks, the Romans, or the Byzantines. Neither did medieval Europe. And despite major destruction, Nazism and communism also failed in their aims to destroy the Jewish people. And I can assure you this, that neither will anti-Semitism succeed in defeating us. Anti-Semites may hurt us, but the Jewish people will continue to prevail. Am Yisrael Chai. The Jewish people live and will always choose life. Thank you.